Hi everyone. So many a times when you appear for job interview or a B-school interview, you are asked to talk about your strengths and weaknesses. Now this is a slightly tricky question because if you talk about too many strengths, you may come out as an overconfident person. At the same time, if you honestly disclose your weakness, then that may also not go very well. So in this particular video, I'm going to tell you how to tackle this question and what are the do's and don'ts about this particular answer. So please watch this video till the end. Before we go ahead, this is a bit about myself. My name is Ronak Shah and you can continue learning with me. You can quickly join my Telegram group. It is anacadmy_Ronak Shah. The link has been provided in the description and do not forget to subscribe to this channel. In fact, if you like this video, then press the like button and please share it with your friends also. So some important points about this particular question when you answer this question. The first thing is I always recommend students to mention 2 to 3 strengths. Okay, do not mention about 4 or 5 different strengths that I'm hardworking, I'm honest, I'm extremely intelligent, I'm quite flexible. Don't talk it that way. Carefully identify what are your actual strengths, because sometimes you may also have to share an example where you have demonstrated this strength, right? So it's always a good idea to be prepared with 2 to 3 strengths that you actually perceive are yours, right? Second point is just mention about one weakness. Do not talk about many weaknesses. Okay, we don't want to defame ourselves over there, right? And it is compulsory to mention one weakness. You can't say that I don't have any weakness. Okay, fine. So you need to be ready about the example, to share one example which can testify your strength. For example, I'm saying that I'm extremely hardworking. Being a hard worker is my strength. And then I can support with this example that if you look at my academics, they have been consistently good. So that showcases that I'm a hardworking person. Talk about the measures that you are taking to overcome your weakness. So whenever you talk about a weakness, you need to mention, you need to talk about what measures are you taking. For example, I'm a little short tempered. And to overcome this weakness, I have been practicing meditation for last 1 year and it has helped me a lot. So this is how whenever you talk about weakness, even if they're not asking, you can just mention by your own that this is what you are doing to overcome that weakness. And this will really go very well. So here I have given some examples of strength. So my strength can be being a hardworking nature, discipline, a good problem solver, and so on and so forth. One more thing that I'll mention over here is when you talk about a strength, try to use adjectives or small phrases rather than long sentences, right? So for example, you want to mention that you are flexible. Instead, I've seen many people putting the sentence that I go along with people very nicely. Even if I'm somewhere, I can gel with people very easily. Don't speak so much. Just mention that I'm flexible. Okay. Or I'm an extrovert. Whatever you think, describe yourself best. Similarly, when you talk about a weakness, do not say I'm very sensitive or I'm very short tempered. No, that will not go very well. You can always use words like a bit short tempered, a bit sensitive, and so on and so forth, right? So that will be appreciated. Okay, for example, I have shared the measure that I'm taking for my weakness. So however, I have been practicing meditation for the last 2 years and it has helped me overcome this to a certain extent. So always talk about the steps that you are taking about your weakness. So I'm sure you would have understood how to talk about your strengths and weaknesses. I have already released few more videos about the other areas of interview, other frequently asked questions of interview, like tell me something about yourself, what are your hobbies, the difference between hobbies and areas of interest. So please watch all my videos and keep learning with me. In fact, if you are CAT 2021 or CAT 2022 aspirant, you can definitely attend my daily live sessions over here on this YouTube channel as well as on Anacadmy Learning app. For that, you should have downloaded Anacadmy Learning app. In case if you haven't done it, then please do it right away. And after downloading it, unlock it using my code SHAH10 and keep learning with me. Also, my Telegram group link has been provided in the description. So please join me over there. And you can also go for our plus subscription and you can attend regular batches. You can get personal guidance and you can get test series and many other features. So please go for plus using my referral code once again, SHAH10. Our new batches are starting every month. Plenty of new batches are starting. So you can start with any of this batch. So that's it as far as this video is concerned. Please stay tuned for more such video. Do not forget to like this video. Thank you.